good day. Ain't that a beautiful start? I don't have a real subject to talk about today. I had something, but I just forgot. And the main reason why I'm riding today is because I actually went to work today for the first time in at least the first time this year, but probably the first time in a couple of months. And especially to this location. The other location I visit more often in the end of 2017. So yeah, one of the reasons why I wanted to take the bike to work today is because I wanted to check out this new jacket I got, which is rather resistant, and my old one isn't. And I will talk more about it in a later video, but yeah, that's one of the main reasons why I went out today, just to try this jacket out, see if it fits, if it's not too tight. I got some things that I notice in the first try, and because this is the first day, it's actually sunny the whole day. Upcoming weekend will be very, very nice, but I will have to work on Saturday, and there's more than enough stuff to do for the Sunday, so that's busy enough as it is. I did go to Houten, the expo. I didn't end up selling the baby. The only person that I might have sold it to didn't come. The other person that was interested in buying, I declined. The feeling wasn't right. You know, and there's more stuff in life, and there's more important stuff in life than money. Animal health is one of those. And for me, that's a very important one as well. So I just honestly said no to him, and maybe later, if he gets all the requirements for his enclosure right, then maybe I sell to him. I said it like this: if you get everything right by the next expo I'm going to, you can have him, but not in the current situation. And he understood it partly, but he wasn't happy. So I don't think he's coming back to me, and I'm fine with that. Then don't come back. The car problem is most likely fixed. We are going to go to the lease program, but we're going to lease a second hand, so a car that has been leased before. Beautiful corner. So many bikers are waving at this time. It's great. In the summertime, all those certain group of bikers, you know, they don't wave back. So the sport bikers don't wave to most other bikes. The Harleys don't wave towards most other bikes. But now, early winter or early spring, so right at the beginning or the end of riding season, when only diehards are riding, or the people that want to get every little bit of drop of riding they can, those people are riding and those people are waving, and they are waving to everyone, because everybody is in the same conditions: the cold, the dark. The level of respect seems to be higher. So yeah, I'm not doing a lot of lane splitting today. There's multiple reasons. One of them is that my mirrors aren't properly adjusted. For some reason they're a little bit off. The second one is one thing I noticed this morning. I am gonna lane split right here though. The second reason is quite a simple reason, but I noticed that even though I've been riding throughout the winter, I haven't been doing commute rides, nor have I done any riding during the rush hour. I do notice that some certain things have become less sharp, let's say it like that. When you do commute riding every single day, you got that rhythm, you got, you know, the locations where you need to watch out, and you're just way, way sharper. When you're doing fun rides, you ride your own tempo, you ride your own routes. If something is too busy, you take another route, you know, you can fully adjust yourself and the way you ride, and you don't have to deal with rush hour maniacs. I cannot imagine that after 4 or 5 or maybe even 6 months of non-riding, you just jump on the bike and go to work and go towards work, or hit full on speeds and try to hit every apex, because that's dangerous. There must be some window of learning every single year again. That must be. And I think that if you don't take that window, even if it's only 2 or 3 rides, but if you don't take that window, then you're dangerous. Now, I do believe that a lot of people will disagree on me with that statement, because a lot of people are either very convinced of their riding skills, or they think that once you learn something, you won't unlearn it. Especially when you haven't been riding at all for 4 or 5 months, there is a learning curve. You cannot disprove that. There is a learning curve. I know there are people out there who on the first day they are riding again, jump on the bike and go across dikes and country roads and trying to do the same shit they did the last day they ride. And apparently most times that goes correctly. Other days that won't go correctly. You can see that in the news. Early season, the number of bike crashes is increased exponentially. So yeah, this morning I noticed that rush hour riding is different than what I did the last couple of months, and I had to fine tune some things. I had to tweak my driving skills a little bit, especially where my eyes are going. And I don't mind that. I mean, I've been riding all year round for years. It's the second or third year I slowed down during winter time, because I have a car, because I have a girlfriend, because I have a house, because of many, many reasons. Mainly because I have a car. But before that, I was 24/7 every single day out there. It's good for me that I notice that difference, that I can tweak the things that need to be different. That means that I'm actively riding, but it does make me wonder, how do people do it when they are not riding for so many months? For the people that say that it isn't true, are they the ones that either subconsciously adjust their riding skill, or are they just the ones that never really push it to the limit? So the early starting season isn't different from the late season because there's no progress at all. I mean, that could be a possibility. Or does it have different reasons? Showing off, thinking you're more skilled than you actually are, which I think is a problem amongst some bikers for sure. I think I don't see myself as a very skilled rider. Even though I've been riding for 7 or 8 years, there's still much I can learn. I'm not a skilled enduro rider, not at all. My off-road skills are very, very low. I haven't done a single track day, so there's a lot of stuff I can learn in that area. So my learning, let's say my learning curve, is still rising each year. But I don't believe that I reach the full potential of this bike, or the full potential of me. So we are joining this biker. The very clean bike, who is taking it slowly, slowly and safely. That's fine. I respect that choice. What I do want to say is to people who haven't been riding for the last couple of months, do start slowly, take your time, be safe, mostly be safe, and enjoy riding, because the season is starting again. You can all enjoy your bikes, you can all go outside and feel the freedom, feel the power of the bike and the community. Do group rides. Oh, I can't wait for a couple of group rides. So yeah, enjoy this beautiful year. Take your bike outside and enjoy it. And we'll talk to you guys later.